আসসালামু আলাইকুম এভরিবডি, আই অ্যাম মোহাম্মদ সাইফুল ইসলাম চৌধুরী, টিচার সিজেএম হাই স্কুল চট্টগ্রাম। ওয়েলকাম টু আওয়ার অনলাইন ক্লাস সিজেএম হাই স্কুল অনলাইন একাডেমি। মাই ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্ট, হাউ আর ইউ? আই হোপ ইউ আর অল ওয়েল বাই দ্য গ্রেস অফ অল মাইটি আল্লাহ। I am also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Today I am going to discuss with you a new topics from English for Today for class 10. Are you all ready? I hope you are all ready. Let's enjoy the class. My dear student, I am showing you some picture. Look at the picture carefully and try to guess what our today's lesson may be. Look at the picture. Eating together looks happy. Eating alone looks monotonous. Which one do you dislike between the two? I hope you must dislike eating alone. Living with family, living alone. My dear student, which one do you dislike between the two? You must dislike living alone. My dear learners, today our lesson is, can you live alone? Unit 1, Lesson 1. My dear learners, if you follow the class attentively, after finishing the class, you will be able to read and understand text through silent reading, narrate incident, participate in discussion, listen to and understand others, and describe something in writing. My dear learners, I am going to read out the passage. Listen to me carefully. Long ago, a young man found life in the family in his village full of problems and sufferings. Quarrels, ill feelings, jealousy, enmity, all are part of everyday life there. So he left his house and went to a jungle to live by himself. There he made a nice little hut with wood, bamboo, and reeds. Ah, how happy I am here, said the man to himself. But one day he found some mice in his hut. The little creatures soon made holes in his blanket. So he brought a cat to kill the mice. The cat needed milk, so he brought a cow. The cow needed grass and hay, so he brought a cowboy. The cowboy needed food, so he took a wife to cook meals. Then children were born to them, and the man found himself again in a family. So nobody can live alone unless they are either angels or devils. People need food, shelter, companions, and cooperation. They need to help each other. And if they live in a family or community, their need can be fulfilled. Hence, living in society can make people good and happy citizens. My dear learners, now read it silently. Start silent reading. My dear learners, let's learn some new words with meanings. First one is sufferings. Sufferings means hardship, orthat dukkho kosto. The young man found his social life full of problems and sufferings. Jealousy. Jealousy means grudge, irsha kora. The girl feels jealousy to the other girl. Cowherd. Cowherd means cowboy, orthat rakhal balok. A cowherd took after the cow. Enmity. Enmity means animosity. Shatruta. Enmity destroys friendship. Companion. Companion means associate, shungi, shathi. We cannot live without companion. My dear learners, choose the best answer from the alternative. Here are four answers given. One is correct answer and another three is distractor. Which of the following has the closest meaning to the word enmity? Animosity. The man dares society to live in a jungle. Abandoned. What does the word companion mean in the passage? Companion means partner. A dash was brought to kill the mice. A cat was brought. He made a dash in the midst of the jungle. He made a shelter. The word jealousy means envy. My dear student, what five things did the young man do in the jungle? The young man made a nice little hut in the jungle. He brought a cat to kill the mice. He brought a cow to have milk. He brought a cowherd to tend the cow, and he took a wife to cook food. My dear learners, tell the story to the group sequentially. Long time ago, a young man got frustrated with his social life because he found it full of problems. So he left his house and made a nice hut in the jungle. He wished to live in the hut peacefully, but soon in the hut the mice made holes in his blanket. So he brought a cat to kill the mice, and he brought a cow for milk to feed the cat. Then he brought a cowherd to look after the cow. At last, he took a wife to cook food. Then children were born to them. Finally, the man found himself again in a family. My dear learners, read the passage carefully and answer the following questions. Why did the young man leave his house? Where did he make a hut? What did he make the hut with? Was the man happy in his heart? How did he find himself again in a family? Where and how can a person be happy? And what is the moral of the story? Now compare with your answer. The young man found his social life full of problems and sufferings, so he left his house. He made a hut in a jungle. He used wood, bamboo, and reeds to make the hut. At first, the man was happy in his hut, but soon his happiness faded away. When the young man found some mice in his hut, he brought a cat. The cat needed milk, so he brought a cow. The cow needed grass and hay, so he brought a cow hen. Then he took a wife and children were born, and thus he found himself again in a family. A person can be happy in the family and by living with the other people in the society. The moral of the story is man cannot live alone. My dear learners, now fill in the blanks with the correct words. Once a young man decided to live by himself in a jungle. He left human society as there were problems and sufferings all the times. In the jungle, he found happiness that he sought. However, his happiness came to an end when he found mice in his hut. Eventually, he learned the importance of the living in a society amidst the cooperation of others. My dear student, what can we do at home and in the locality to become a good citizen? To be good citizen, first of all, we must increase our consciousness and develop our skills. Besides going to school, we have to go to libraries and develop the habit of studying a lot. We must show respect to the elders and sympathy to the poor and the weak. We also have to contribute to establishing peace and harmony in the locality. My dear student, here is a homework for you. Write a paragraph within 10 sentences about the problems and the comforts of the living in a society. My dear learners, that's all for today. Thank you. Thank you very much.